Good morning, church family. I am excited to be here today on Saturday, April the 4th. I hope that today is a great day for you. I just first want to say thank you for all the encouragement in the comments yesterday about doing this video series. It was a blessing to me. I think that helps us keep connected whenever we comment and just talk to each other digitally or on social media or whatever, so thank you. But then also I want to let you know that tomorrow, on Sundays, I am not going to be doing a daily devotion because our regular service at 10 o'clock is broadcast online. Pastor Zach does an amazing job teaching, and so I want to encourage you to be there tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock to watch online at fbfirst.com. So thank you again, and hope you catch that tomorrow morning. It's going to be a great service. So with that, let's dive into the scriptures today. Today we're going to be in Genesis chapter 21. We're going to actually read verses 15 through 19, but I have to set this up real fast to let you know what's going on. Abram, who we talked about yesterday, has his name changed to Abraham. God has promised him to be a father of many nations. He has no children, and around 86 years old, he decides to take it in his own hands, and so he has a child with his, not his wife, but his slave, basically Hagar, and they have a son named Ishmael. About 99, so about 14 years later, 99 or 100, at 100 years old, that's whenever Sarah, his wife, actually has a child named Isaac. And that's whenever this starts to take place, because it says whenever Isaac was just being weaned, that Ishmael starts to mock him or laugh at him. At least that's what Sarah sees. And so Sarah gets really mad and wants Abraham to get rid of Hagar and get rid of Ishmael. And Abraham's kind of concerned about it, but then God actually says to Abraham to listen to Sarah. And so what happens is Abraham one morning packs up some food and some water, and it's water and some skins, that's what they called it, water and skins, in the skins, and so gave it to Hagar and sent Hagar and Ishmael along the way. And this is where we pick up in verse 15 of chapter 21 in Genesis. It says, "When the water in the skin was gone, she put the boy under one of the bushes. Then she went off and sat down about a bow shot away, for she thought, 'I cannot watch the boy die.' And as she sat there, she began to sob." She began to just profusely cry. "And God," now listen to this, "God heard the boy crying. And the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven and said to her, 'What is the matter, Hagar? Do not be afraid.'" That's our verse, that's our little phrase. "Do not be afraid. God has heard the boy crying as he lies there. Lift the boy up and take him by the hand, for I will make him into a great nation." And then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. So she went and filled the skin with water and gave the boy a drink. I want you to understand what's happening here is Hagar gets so overwhelmed with her situation, so overwhelmed with the dire need of what is going on, that she just gives up. She absolutely, totally gives up, places Ishmael underneath a bush, goes over about a bow shot away, and just starts crying and just crying because she doesn't want to see her child die. But then God does something amazing. God says, the Bible says that God hears the cry of the boy, and then addresses Hagar and says, basically, "Well, don't be afraid. I will provide." He says, "Hagar, don't be afraid. I know your situation. I know what you're going through. I'm sure he heard Hagar crying, but the Bible says that he heard the boy crying. So he knows the situation. He knows what's going on. He says, "Don't be afraid. I know the situation, and I will provide." And so what I want to do today is this, is I want to encourage you, no matter where you are in this strange times, maybe you're doing okay, and maybe it's, you know, you're just going along, it's just a little bump in the road for you. Or maybe it's a very serious thing right now where you are. Maybe you have some family members that are sick with the virus, or maybe you've lost a job. or maybe you're scared to death and you're just anxious and you don't know what's going on. You don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. You don't even know what today's going to bring, much less tomorrow. What I want to say is this: be encouraged. God knows the situation. God knows your situation. He knows what's going on. And He, I believe, He will provide. He always does. In this text, God is the provider. And what does He provide? He provides a well. Now, this is fascinating to me because a lot of times whenever we are praying to God and crying out to God, we want God to change our situation totally and completely, but He doesn't do that. He provides exactly what we need. And that's what He did in this text. He provided Hagar and Ishmael a well. And what they had to do is Hagar had to get up, pick up the boy, take the boy to the well, fill the skins with water, and then give the boy a drink. So she had something to do there as well. It wasn't just like God filled the skins, and He could do that, but He didn't. He just gave them exactly what they needed. And so in your situation today, no matter where you are, God is provider. He will give you exactly what you need. Maybe it's just a glimmer of hope. He will give you that. Maybe it's, I don't know what it is, but maybe it's whatever you need today. Look for it. Open your eyes like Hagar did to see the well, to see that little bit of hope that you need, because God is our provider. And so today what we want to do is we want to pray for, I really want to pray for our first responders, our police officers, our EMTs, our firefighters. They normally go into dangerous situations whenever they respond to a call, but I think in this strange times that they are going into even heightened dangerous situations. So I just want to pray for, or no, I want to be thankful for them. This is our gratitude time. I want to be thankful for our firefighters and our EMTs and our police officers, because they are doing their job. And thank you to all of you guys who are that. I have some friends that are firefighters and EMTs and police officers. So thank you very much for what you do. I am very grateful for that. And then also today, what I want to do is I want to pray for those that have lost their jobs. And that kind of hits home with what the characteristic of God is today. God is provider. And so for those of you that have lost your job or been furloughed or maybe even working that aren't getting paid, I'm praying for you today. Listen, God, I know it's hard. I know the situation seems weird. It seems strange. It seems like there is no hope. But there is hope. In Christ Jesus, there is hope. And I pray that you get that little glimpse of hope today. And I pray that you today will open up your eyes, maybe, I don't know, but you'll open up your eyes just like it happened with Hagar, and you'll see what God provides for you. And I'm praying for that provision today for you. So let's pray. God, I just thank you. God, I am so grateful for your son, Jesus. I'm grateful for the grace and mercy that comes through him. God, I am thankful for the firefighters and the EMTs and the police officers that are still doing their jobs as they are running into They already always run into dangerous situations, but God, they're running into even more dangerous situations now. And so, God, I just thank you for them. I'm grateful for them. And God, my heart goes out to you right now, those that have lost their jobs, those that are struggling, maybe financially, those that are anxiety-ridden because they're so scared of what's happening next. I have a friend, Lord, that's in that situation up in Atlanta, great friend of mine. Lord, I just pray for those that have lost their jobs. God, I pray that you would show them, that you would provide for them, that you would show them your provision for them. God, you may not change their situation, but you will provide. Just like you provided the well, God, you will provide for them. And I believe that wholeheartedly. So God, I lift them up to you. I pray that you would shower them with your love this morning, this day. In Jesus' name, amen. So guys, wherever you are, whatever you're going on, remember that God is our provider. He is your provider. He is my provider. I love you guys. I miss you guys. We miss you guys as a staff. Can't wait to get together, but right now this is where it's going to be. So just remember, turn down the volume of the media, turn up the volume of truth that's in God's Word. Look to Him, and in Christ Jesus there is hope. God bless. Have a great Saturday.